Hey guys, so this video is about entrepreneurs in the healthcare field. And what brought me to make this or talk about this topic is the fact that going through anesthesia residency, nobody really ever taught us about the business of anesthesia. And we spent a lot of time learning about how to do anesthesia for open heart surgery, how to do anesthesia for thoracic surgery, how to do anesthesia for pregnant patients, how to do anesthesia. And we focused a lot on our clinical skills during that time. And that was great. And I learned a lot and I got very good at it. And that is what you need. Your skill set basically coming out of residency is what determines your place in the marketplace and your marketability. And a lot of people, my fellow colleagues and my classmates in residency, they went on to do fellowships and specialize and do a lot more regional or pain management or pain medicine and things of that nature. But what nobody I ever felt taught us about was the business of anesthesia and how important it is for us to understand. And I think that is probably why we don't have a lot of physician leaders and a lot of anesthesiologists getting out of residency and pursuing, healthcare business and entrepreneurial positions in the market. And I think that we're led to believe that we are a clinical instrument of service and that we are physicians or we are people who provide great anesthesia care. But I think that that is a real big missing part of our training, where we need to be taught about how payer contracts work. We need to be taught about how negotiations take place with hospitals. We need to learn about what does your payer mix determine, or what impact that has on your revenue. We need to be taught about delivering value to components of various aspects to the healthcare field, right? Of your clients. And the list goes on and on. And I think that if we were taught that, if residents get taught that type of stuff, they're more likely to actually grow an interest in it. And after growing an interest, pursuing it in a meaningful way where they can then go and do things with it, rather than being a cog on the wheel of this repetitive pumping out of healthcare providers. And that's great. So it's not, entrepreneurship isn't meant for everybody. Not everybody wants to do it, and that's perfectly fine. But I think that there's a lot of people, especially including me, who I got out of residency feeling like that, man, okay, so this is it, this is my job, and this is what I'm doing. And yes, I felt confident, I felt good, I felt great about it, but there was a whole other book and chapter and part of this entire business that I completely had no idea about. I knew it existed, but I had no idea about it. And perhaps, yes, you can say that I should have maybe taken more time to learn about it while in residency, but we're so geared towards the clinical aspect of it that we don't get time, or we don't get people teaching us these things. And I think that needs to change. And I know that there are MBA and MD and combined programs and other places, but I think this needs to happen more and more. And I think that it's our responsibility to teach other future waves and generations of anesthesiologists and healthcare providers coming into this space to be entrepreneurial, to be able to get out in the marketplace, get out in the arena and see what's going on, how can I deliver value, and how much fun I can have doing the business of anesthesia.